The next case law is Jai Prakash versus Messrs. National Insurance Company and others. This case law was decided in the year 2009. The Supreme Court, while taking into consideration various aspects of the Motor Vehicles Act of 1988, had brought about four different directions which were not incorporated in the 2019 Amendment Act. The major problems with the 1988 Act were addressed by the Supreme Court in this case. However, no heed was paid by the legislature while amending the 2019 Amendment. These are important for our consideration while studying the Motor Vehicles Act, and let us consider this case law in detail. So there are a total of four problems that were considered by the Supreme Court that were in existence in the Motor Vehicles Act of 1988. So the first problem was with respect to victims of road accident who did not get compensation. So according to the lawyer, there are two types of victims: one who get compensation and the second are who do not get compensated at all. So it was asserted that people or victims of an accident wherein it involved an insured vehicle or where the victim was sure of getting compensation by the insurer fall in the first category, whereas victims of motor accidents involving the following categories are generally the victims of the second category, that is, who do not get compensation at all. So who are these victims? So the first case is of hit and run case where the vehicle remains unidentified. So as the vehicle is unidentified, who is supposed to pay the victim? There will be no insurance company will come forward to pay these victims. The second is vehicles which do not have insurance cover. So even though there are policies made about having compulsory insurance, there are still people who travel without insurance or with expired insurance. So what about a person who meets with an accident by such a vehicle? It is not his fault, but what about the compensation? The insurance company will definitely deny paying compensation to these victims. The next is vehicles with third-party insurance carrying persons who are not covered by the insurance. So who are these people? For example, the gratuitous passengers in goods vehicles. So when you meet with an accident, the driver and the passenger will be compensated. But what about the people who have been traveling in the bus or the goods vehicle wherein passengers are not allowed? Or it can be a pillion rider on a two-wheeler. So generally, the driver of the vehicle is compensated, but the pillion driver is not compensated. So when a person is hit by an uninsured vehicle or by such a vehicle which does not cover gratuitous passengers, what is to be done in such a situation? Are they not liable to get compensation? Because the victim does not choose which car to be hit by, and furthermore, it is also not the fault of the victim. So what is to be done in such a situation was a perplexing question before the court. There are a total of 20% victims who fall in the second category and who do not get insurance at all. You may say that if the insurance company does not pay, yet in case of an uninsured vehicle, the owner of the vehicle or the driver make compensation. But in many circumstances, it so happens that the driver or the owner of the vehicle does not have enough or sufficient funds to compensate the victim. Furthermore, there have been cases whereas the driver or the owner of the vehicle has siphoned his funds as well as property in order to get away from the liability of paying compensation to these victims. So, is it a fault of the victim? In such situations where a victim is not given compensation, feels frustrated and discriminated when he has not been compensated, whereas a similar person who has been hit by an insured vehicle gets compensation immediately. Furthermore, the main object of creating insurance and funds with respect to hit and run cases is that the person gets monetary compensation during the golden hour. But when there is no insurance to pay the compensation in the first case, how do we save more lives and how do we protect the object of the act? The state has provided that there shall be compulsory insurance as well as third-party insurance to protect the motor accident victims. Yet, there are still 20% victims who do not get compensation at all. The state must do something with this aspect to reduce the incidence of non-insurance, and it should also provide some effective remedy to grant compensation to these 20% of people. Now let's move to the second problem that has been discussed with the case. The second problem was with respect to widespread use of goods vehicle to carry passengers. So as we know that a goods vehicle cannot carry passengers for hire, but we've seen in numerous rural areas and also on highways that there are more than 15 to 20 or more people than even that can be accommodated on a truck have been carried from one place to another. So these can be illegal passengers where they pay certain fare, or these can also be gratuitous passengers when they do not pay fare, but the driver, just by having sympathy on them, gives them a ride and transports them to a different place. So what are the reasons due to which such goods transport vehicles carry passengers? They are, first, non-availability of regular mode of passenger transport. So in urban areas, we have a lot of options. We have rickshaws, we have taxis, we have cabs, we have buses and metros. But what in the case of rural areas? There are no rickshaws and taxis, and not people can afford a vehicle of their own. In these cases, due to lack of public transportation, they prefer traveling in goods carriers. The second reason is non-availability of contract carriages. So when people want to travel in large numbers from one place to another, there might not be buses available or private buses available to carry them from one place to another. So in special occasions such as a festival or a marriage or political rallies, these people prefer to travel in goods vehicle where they can accommodate almost 100 to 200 people in a goods carrier vehicle. So they travel in lorries and tractor trailers on such occasions. The next reason is frequent breakdown of buses, cars and other vehicles. So the government, in spite of making various modes of transportation, they do not care about the maintenance of these vehicles, which causes frequent breakdowns. So for example, if it is a less populated area and the vehicle breaks down in such a situation, the passengers do not have any other option but to travel in a goods carrier vehicle or any other vehicle which gives them a lift to transport them to one place to another. So in this situation as well, they become gratuitous passengers. The next reason is the temptation of lorry drivers to make a quick buck. The drivers may be with the knowledge of the owner of the vehicle and mostly without the knowledge of the motor vehicle owner, generally carry these passengers for hire to make some good money. Be it 100 to 200 rupees, it is generally their daily income with respect to driving such goods vehicle. So when such gratuitous passengers or passengers by paying fare travel in the goods vehicle, knowing or without knowing that such travel is illegal, and such vehicle meets with an accident, various moral as well as legal issues arise before us, and which is arising before the court as well. These questions are, first, whether the victims are entitled to get compensated. As the travel is illegal, no insurance company would come forward to pay them. Second, whether the insurer is liable to compensate the victim. So whether it be the owner in such a situation, as the insurance company specifically states that they will pay insurance only in case of legal accidents or where the driver has followed all the legal regulations. The third is whether the owner, who may not be aware of such illegal carriage by the driver, be made liable. So we've seen in case of drivers, there's a aspect called vicarious liability, where the acts of the driver are also being imposed upon the owner of the vehicle. So even if the accident has been done by the driver, the owner may be held liable in certain situations to pay the victim, because the driver is obviously not in a financial situation to pay compensation of lakhs of rupees to all these victims, but the owner may be rich enough to pay them. Next is whether the owner and driver of goods vehicles should be made liable to pay compensation even when they were carrying the passengers stranded on the road gratuitously or out of sympathy. Now here the owner of the car and the driver are doing a good deed by helping out these passengers. So who will be liable to pay these people in case of an accident? Can you hold the driver or owner of the vehicle liable to pay the compensation? Also, another question arises as to whether these illegal passengers should be denied compensation as a deterrent to discourage unauthorized travel. However, it is important to note that a majority of these unauthorized travels are due to the lack of the state government to provide appropriate transportation policies in rural areas, and also in cases which severe such transportation buses or trucks are broken down. What is to be done in these situations? The third problem in the case put forth before the court was with respect to procedural delay in adjudication and settlement of claims and the consequential hardship to the victims and the families. So generally we see that in deciding motor vehicles claim, though there is a prescribed time limit and directions given by the Supreme Court to settle these claims as soon as possible. However, there are certain reasons due to which delays have been happened in these cases. So what is to be done in this situation? Because when such claims have not been settled and compensation has not been granted at the earliest, it may so happen that the victim undergoes a severe injury because he does not have sufficient funds to pay for his medical expenses. Due to such delay in paying compensation to the road accident victim, a temporary disability may also turn into a permanent disability if compensation is not granted at the appropriate time. It may also happen that when such victim dies in a road accident, there are various dependents on him, such as his wife, his children, his old age parents. When compensation is not granted in case of death of a sole breadwinner of the family, the wife may be forced in order to take different household jobs, and the children might also have to drop out of the educational institutions. So it is necessary to provide compensation to the victims and the families of these victims at the earliest without any delay. The insurance companies are aware of the fact that when such temporary disability of the victim turns into a permanent disability, they will have to grant more compensation or pay more compensation in these situations. They're also aware of the fact that no matter what, they cannot run away from the liability of paying compensation to these road victims. Yet they wait for the victim or the family members of the victim to file a compensation claim in the Motor Vehicles Claims Tribunal, carry on with the deadly procedure and the lending procedure, and then pay compensation to these families. So this issue of untimely settlement of disputes was also put before the court. The fourth problem was respect to full compensation being granted to illiterate or ignorant victims. As in the previous case was discussed that housewives are not granted compensation appropriately, this case law also took a similar view, wherein illiterate and ignorant victims were not granted compensation. So these illiterate victims, as they did not have much salary or they were not employed at all, were not granted sufficient compensation in the Vehicles Act. The court has also observed that in spite of granting compensation to the families of these victims, the compensation does not reach the actual families, as relatives who are educated, as against the family members of the victim who are uneducated, try to garb the compensation by them, and the benefit is actually not received to the victims of the case.